faster, slow motion. I was losing focus, stuck on that. It was smooth on the surface, but underneath it was broken. Hoping to find hope in this hopeless world we live in. What you give is what you're given. Gotta make wise decisions, gotta stay tunnel vision, gotta avoid collision. Keep scratching the surface and keep your palms itching. Gotta pay moms a visit, it's been a while. I've been working, she keep telling me she miss her child. I find myself passing a house, then I spin around. She say I'm always moving, ma, I just can't sit around. Oh my, cause the cash ain't gonna come to us. When we was down, who gave a dime or gave a for us? So instead of making it hard. Keep an eye on me, I know it's been a drought, but to my fans, don't go dry on me. If you want a picture, take a picture, don't get shy on me. I'm here to inspire, I admire that you admire me. I've been in the dark, but I promise you'll see a bite of me. I'm sorry. To all my supporters, man, I love y'all. I just want to say thank you for supporting me since day one. You don't want to see me win, man. I don't know why, but we gonna win anyway. It came straight out the with a microphone. Boy, I swear I couldn't leave that mic alone. Everybody clear the room, I like to write alone. I'm in my zone, bass bouncing off the styrofoam. I'm never in between, I'm either hot or cold. Can't be a loser, I maneuver like I got a clone. I'm out here in these streets like I ain't got a home. And you barely hear from me like I ain't got a phone. Because there's no days off, there's no days off. I know it sounds a little painful, but it pays off. Social sites was distracting, so I stayed off. Spoke to God, then me and Satan had a face off. I swear my life was like a rocket, then it takes off. First I plotted, then I got it, couldn't wait long. I put the pedal to the metal, then took the brakes off. And I kept it A1 like the steak sauce. My paychecks used to be a pair of Jordans, and I know I can't afford them, but I went ahead and bought them. Then I quit, started, spent my money on recording. Yeah, the studio was small, but man, that made me a fortune. Made me a fortune, man. Trying to stop me. Y'all can't stop me. This is forever. Forever, man. I mean that.
Hey, this that Eastside Johnny Big Redemption light. I got bigger plans than staying rich. I've been tap dance since I was six. I tap dance all on them. And your diamonds like tap water. That drip way too foggy. These BBS is way awesome. Park CLS for drop to your death without warning. Get out the way, get out the way. Get out the way, get out my way. Yeah. You
either with me or against me, though. You either with me or win. Win, 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 win.
Yeah.
Curve everything else. Win, 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 win.
Win.
These ops ain't. Win, 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 win. Start chasing that. Win, 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 win.
Yeah.
You clowns really don't stay outside when I play outside. I put the beats on them like Dre outside. I got the bow side and LA outside. And if you act bad, I bring the outside. Go and get your money. None of my know some funny. I can tell real by who you're running with. I'm all in the field. Duck hunt. Hit my just the. And he was like, boop.
Here.
Knew just what it was. The whole but gave it back, boop.
Yeah.
9-11, no malice, baby. But no violence, baby. My got callous, baby. My bare knuckles got talent, baby. I'm all in the wind with it. On deuce line, I've been with it. She too fine, I've been. Crashed 2 times, I limo tinted my new ride. I'm riding with the 12 better not pull me over. Championship going dumb.
Whoa,
nothing
whoa,
to something
whoa.
I won. Get out the way, get out the way, get out the way, yeah.
Yeah.
Get out the way, get out the way, out my way, yeah.
Yeah.
You either with me or against me, though. You either with me or win. Win, 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 win.
Yeah.
Curve everything else. Win, 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 win.
Win.
These ops ain't.
All right, thanks, Coach. EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Seattle Seahawks and the New York Jets. A pair of 3-0 teams set to lock horns for the right to remain unbeaten. And we're off in week 4. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Carry for the former Michigan State man, Le'Veon Bell. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there, second down.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
Well, they had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on second and 10. Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. Got his man, Robbie Anderson. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. 10 yards is the pickup, good enough for a Jet first down.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double-team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
Now a first down carry by Bell. And he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
Second down, it's Bell. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. On third down, he'll drop to throw. He's got Evans. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. So they convert on third with a gain of 22. So again from the 39, this time from the other side of the field. Here's first and 10. On first down, he'll drop to throw. He's got his tight end, Jake Bunt. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
They'll go back to the ground. And he'll go down at the 28. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
Now a whistle and I think a penalty here for a delay. No, they're going to say timeout. They did get the timeout in time. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And they'll keep it on the ground with Bell. Evades him at the 10. That good for 19 and a first down. Quite the opening drive march they're on right now.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script. You go through your play calling. You go through all the stuff and establish things. And it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
First red zone opportunity now for the Jets. They're looking at a first and goal from about the 9. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw, and this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by the all-pro free safety Earl Thomas, and he'll be brought down at his own 10-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, first and 10 from back at their own 10-yard line.
95.
A first carry now for Dalvin Cook. And a short gain here across the 10 to the 12. 2 yards on the carry there, it'll be second down.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
And now some motion before the snap. And this will be our first penalty of the night's proceedings. False start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long.
18. 18. 14.
from the shotgun. Wilson eluding the pressure right. And he'll get it up to the 12-yard line here. He'll end up getting five out of that, but now they're looking at third down. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. And this is going to be incomplete. The linebacker, C.J. Mosley, there in coverage.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
Here we go on fourth with Wilson. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And they will not be able to hook up there. It's incomplete. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game. And now possession will go over inside the 15-yard line. A give to Bell. And he's in. Touchdown, Jets. Le'Veon Bell with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Jets have taken a first quarter lead. Solid job up front. Really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
Yeah, that was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run. End result, 6 points.
Touchdown. Extra point up and through by Myers. And it's now a 7-0 game. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Here come the Seahawks now set to take over on offense. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complimentary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help
it. And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Marcus May with a pick. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Cut. They'll start the drive with a carry by Bell. No, a nifty juke there.
Not much fun for a guy trying to tackle it.
And he puts his head down and gets up to the 42 for a gain of about 6. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards. But also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
And very little daylight there. He'll get a couple up to the 44.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
Ohio! Ohio!
Cut. On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. Found his target, it's Anderson. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first. Just the first quarter, but tackling going to be so important going forward. They've got to limit plays like that.
And that's something when you see it happen early in the game and they don't get him on the ground, you can always tell that they were concerned about it going in. Because I can just tell you, from my days, I remember being in college and worrying all offseason about our season open opponent, and they had a receiver that could shake and bake with the best of them. I tackled him on the first pass of the game, and the relief was incredible. Ended up having a pretty decent ball game. But if I had missed him, it would have been a long night.
And now he'll tuck it and run. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
I think the last two plays really illustrate how difficult it is to game plan against this guy, because you know he can throw the football, but how about his use of legs as well? What we call those broken plays, you can't account for them.
Yeah, those plays, those two that you just mentioned, a microcosm really of how he can hurt you. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. That's caught right side by Anderson. With Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon with you, it's the Jets in possession as we begin quarter number two here. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. The give is to Bell. He takes us down to about the 12 for a gain of 3. I think you mentioned in the opening drive that these guys needed to establish the run, protect the young QB. I actually wrote that down, believe it or not. So how would you assess things so far?
I'm kind of touched that you actually wrote something like that down. I appreciate that, partner. But I do think they've been able to do that. Maybe not as effectively as they've wanted to, but I think we'll see more of as this game goes along, because they want to continue to take care of that young QB.
Bell. Oh, look at that. Oh, and now he bowls him over. He went backwards 7 yards, setting up a tough third down.
I mean, that was an example of why offensive linemen might want rearview mirrors at times, because you have your assignments to block, but if you can see what's going on in the backfield, that maybe the guy carrying the ball is headed in another direction, it might change what you do up front. But if they can't see that, and he's not in sync with what they're doing up front, well, this is when you end up with plays like this. A bad one for the offense, a really good one for the defense.
And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play, as we'll get a timeout. That's their second, so they'll have one remaining here in this second quarter. We'll be right back. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. 51 to 5. Back to throw. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowl safety Cam Chancellor. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And that was a young pup, the rookie, being intercepted by a veteran DB.
And I loved our quick conversation in pregame with him on the field, where he said, hey, look, I love playing these young quarterbacks. They don't know a whole lot yet, so I can use my mind to put me in a position to make a play.
After the interception, here's Wilson. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he'll take this one up to about the 6-yard line. A good convergence there defensively. Only a yard, and it's second down. They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this 2nd and 9. Throwing is Wilson. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line. A solid gain of 15 yards in the sticks move.
They ran that one well, and not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
14, 14, 14.
They'll throw on first down with Wilson. That's caught by his tight end, Evan Ingram. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that was a surprise. And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, C.J. Mosley. And they'll start with great field position at the 41-yard line. He's on quite the interception run. He had 2 last week, another one here. Remember, he's not a DB, he's a linebacker.
But how many of those linebackers started as DBs and pumped themselves up into being linebackers? So the ball skills are the same, right? The coverage skills and responsibilities are the same, and he is paying it off in a big, big way.
Forced out to his left. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete. Tried to get that one to Jake Butt, and it's second down.
Well, they're slinging it. And then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
It came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach and incomplete. Here now is 2nd and 10, again from the 41. Forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up 3rd down. The Jets on 3rd down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 11. He'll look to throw. Buying time to his left. Evans has it left side. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. A gain of 19 in picking up the first.
And there was absolutely zero pressure on the quarterback on that play. 3rd down, and he has all the time in the world to eventually find an open receiver for a 1st down pickup.
Cut. They'll look to throw now on 1st down. Got a man, it's caught. Touchdown. Jets. Robbie Anderson, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Jets find a way to stretch their lead. And partner, they found a gap there on the post pattern, and it was in the middle third of the field.
And that's really difficult to do because ordinarily the safeties are back there to prevent that happening. But they found the opening and exploited it.
Myers connects on the PAT, and it's now 14-0. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the 1st half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything, at least 3 points, get that 0 off the board. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. A gain of 3, 2nd down.
I don't think any of us were surprised that they decided to start this drive on the ground after the last 2 drives ended in interceptions.
Unfortunately, though, not a lot going on that 1st play.
Yeah, I think the anticipation was felt also by the defense.
Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. On 2nd down, here's Wilson.
Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play. And just like that, it's third down. It's Wilson. Dancing to his left. He can run for it, and he will. And he will be knocked down hard, but he will have the first down. The rushing numbers for Wilson may be down from earlier in his career, but he's still a threat to go, showing it there, picking up the first down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. He hits Jermaine Kearse. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
Well, that was a pretty favorable situation there. What would you call that, second and manageable? Smart play, too. Didn't force it downfield when he didn't have it. Just checked it down. Let him get the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
Now Wilson on first down. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. He lost 9 there. That's really going to set him back for second down. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We'll come back to MetLife Stadium after this short timeout. Play action. Now Wilson. Airing one deep for Kearse. And a hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Throwing again here, Wilson. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. Seems like this defense, especially the secondary, has really been contesting about every throw in this first half.
Remind me of a good half-court defensive basketball team. Every time a pass is thrown, they're right there in good defensive position, able to affect the play.
He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. The Jets offense now works their way back onto the field, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
They'll start out on the ground with Bell. He's got room to run past the 20. Le'Veon Bell, kiss him goodbye.
the way in. Touchdown, New York. Le'Veon Bell, 95 yards. And the Jets are going to add on to their lead. And with that carry, he's already over 100 yards here in the first half.
And partner, you know exactly what he's saying to his teammates right now, right? Especially to the play caller.
Give me the ball.
Again. And again.
And again.
And again. It's not that heavy, sir. I'll take it.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And out now come the Seahawks. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
First down, Wilson. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And now running right through it. They'll wind up losing 11 on the play. And it'll make this a second and long.
I really don't know where to go with this one. He caught the pass, but in the opposite direction towards his own end zone. That's not one you get every game.
The first down play, to be frank, nothing short of awful. And now they have to deal with second and very long. Second down, Cook. And he takes us across the 15 to the 17. Give him 4 yards there, but still in a big hole. Third and long.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
Long, it's Wilson over the middle. He's got his tight end Ingram, and he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. It's a 15-yard pickup, but it'll lead to a fourth down. Well, the offense failed earlier on the previous crack at this, but they're going again on fourth down. They'll indeed go for it with Wilson. And Wilson's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by the linebacker, C.J. Mosley. And he's given his guys a shot for late points as they will take over in range for a field goal or maybe more. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. They'll run it with Bell. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring up a second and 11. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. So with 2 ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. This will be from 49 yards out. And now a timeout defensively after that first down play. So they're going to make this offense sweat out half number one. So with 2 ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. This will be from 49 yards out. And Myers able to knock it through. So we've hit halftime here at MetLife Stadium with the home team, the Jets, leading this one. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This one fielded at the 5.
Oh, nice spin.
Oh, that brought back bad memories.
The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to come back onto the field. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution? Or did they think they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they feel like they had something going, but they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out. Again, on first down, Cook finding some room at midfield. A big hitter there, a first down gain of 26 yards.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there, I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
So a first and five now after the 5-yard penalty from the neutral zone infraction. Cook following the penalty. And not much running room. Down to the 32. And just a yard on the pickup there. It'll be second and four.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
Now they'll throw it with Wilson. Being chased out left. And they'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
Sometimes guys get locked into such a groove. What do we call it? The game slowing down. They see everything happening almost in slow motion. They see the lanes develop. I feel like he's right there.
Well, and you want this from your leader, right? With this deficit, this stage of the game, second half, no quit in him.
Zero.
Took till the second half, but finally a red zone opportunity here. First and 10 right at the 20. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Flushed out, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. That's their first time getting to the quarterback, sack number one. And, you know, they had five last week, I'm remembering.
And you have to find a way to slow down the pass rush, not necessarily with just protecting your quarterback, but you show them a lot of different looks, and they did that in the first half. You know, different angles, different things to slow down the speed. They got to him here in the second half. Now they've got to come up with a counter to that and maybe do something different.
Now Wilson on second down. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. It's a loss of two. Now third down. Well, they try to swing it out left into the flat. Complete, but really nice open field tackling.
And they played that one like a great boxer. They were on their toes on that one. They weren't back on their heels reacting to the play. No, they saw it, came right for it, and made a nice tackle for lost yardage.
On third down, Wilson. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. And a loss of three to bring up four. Well, you can see what they wanted to do. They wanted to set up the screen there, but it got blown up.
It's hard to run that play if you're not getting a lot of pressure at the quarterback because the space doesn't open up. They were able to read that one and slow it down and stop it before they could get a first down.
Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth.
They'll try and throw for it with Wilson. And my goodness, this is incomplete. The linebacker C.J. Mosley there in coverage. And that makes him now 0-for-3 on fourth down attempts.
A lot of people would say they're showing a lot of guts going for it this many times on fourth down. I think they'd have to start thinking with their head a little bit more than with their gut and their emotions, because it's not working for them. They've got to figure out what's been going wrong.
They'll pitch it out to Bell. And he'll get this one up to the 26. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
And then he goes with a juke, and he works free. Touchdown of the game, number 9 on the season. And this Jets offense continues to pour it on. Extra point up and through by Myers. And that'll push the lead up to 29 now. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
And they will not get a chance to return this one, as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And the Seahawks get ready to trot out on the field. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go around?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach, because this is what he preaches all the time.
Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. But I believe a Seahawk was able to get a handle on this, so this will remain Seattle ball.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
And he's got it. Got his man on the end route. Complete. And he's able to get up here to the 26. A good pickup there. 13 yards as they get closer for third down. The Seahawks on third down. Just 1-for-5 to this point. This is 3rd and 9. Wilson. It's caught. Lockett. And a loose football. And the Jets have recovered. Well, he did what he's known for. He made the catch, then he turned into a runner, took the contact, and coughed it up.
And all I remember as a player, when they catch the ball, when those acrobatic guys catch it, you have to make them pay sometimes. You have to put it on them. Big tackle. Knock the ball free. Anything you can do to slow them down.
This is Bell. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a 2nd and just about a few inches here.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Again, it's Bell. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and now they're faced with a 3rd and 1. Yeah, baby. Boom. The Jets on 3rd down. They've been good, 3-for-4 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. They're going to look to throw. He may try and run for this. So no sack. He gets back to the line of scrimmage, but it'll still bring up a 4th down.
And while he did a good job of sliding around in the pocket, there was nowhere to go with the football, so he had to take off and try and run. He just got back to the line of scrimmage. No gain.
Myers able to knock it through. And they're sitting pretty now as the lead grows even further. So he splits the uprights, and has to be a nice feeling. Right when it left his foot, knew it was good.
Yeah, just like a good three-point shooter in basketball, right? Release the ball, fall back on defense without even looking. You know it's going in the hoop.
They juked him. Come on, now he bowls it over. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Big word. I like it, though, because you're exactly
right. You like that, don't you?
All game long, they've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession. Is that word again, symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis, symptomatic of the success of this broadcast.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Again on second and 10, it's Wilson. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. He was trying to get it to Jermaine Kearse, and it's third down.
Maybe a little frustration starting to creep in. The offensive line hasn't done a great job of protecting him in this game, and there he was, hit again as he threw it.
Yeah, another time on his backside, probably starting to get a little frustrated.
Got to keep his composure. Can't let the defense know that they're getting to him.
Here's Wilson. And an alley to run. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. Opted to run for it. The decision a good one. Picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. On first and 10, it's Wilson. Flush to his right. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
Containing him is becoming a big problem. We've already seen this once earlier in this drive.
Yeah, and so now two times this has happened. Do you adjust something?
Yeah, I think you do. I think you got to start thinking about your rush lanes. Try not to either get too wide or too narrow. Make sure someone is there waiting for him to take off.
A couple of first downs on the drive already as they'll go from the 47 now on first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. The decision is to decline it and not give him the down back.
They might as well have sent a skywriter above the stadium saying, "We don't think you can get the first down against our defense by that decision."
On second down, Wilson. This complete to Lockett. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Wilson to Lockett there for the Seahawk first down. Hard to believe his first catch of the game defensively. They bottled him up. That's why they're well on their way to victory.
Put your best cover guy on him and then change the coverages behind him throughout the game. Brackets, double, zone, man, you name it. Make sure he gets a lot of angles. I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
It's caught on the left side by Kearse. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
Keep working, baby. Keep working, fellas.
From the red zone now, here's Wilson on first down. Throw left side, complete to Ingram.
And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. That throw good for four. It's second down.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit, because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into his windows.
And he will take this one in for the Seattle touchdown. Russell Wilson, his 14th touchdown now on the year. And the Seahawks are able to close the gap just a bit. Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And that will get him one closer. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This one fielded at the five. Now a hit and a loose football. And this drive will start on the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line.
There's never a good place on the field to fumble the ball. Let's just call it as it is.
But definitely not in your own red zone.
In your own red zone, it's heightened, isn't it? Because you're almost automatically giving up a score and the momentum, and everything just changes for your team.
Yeah, so the kickoff fumble, now great field position. Throw on first down with Wilson. And he will find his man on the outside. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. That throw good for four. It's second down. Four yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six.
Check 50.
I got 83. Me. Throwing is Wilson. And that one got tipped. Kind of threw everything off. It brings up third. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden the secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six. Now Wilson. He'll complete this to Ingram, his tight end. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. It's a gain of six as they're able to convert, and now it's first and goal. Two of their three red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. They'll run with Cook. And he'll get about four there as he takes it from the 10 down to the six. So that run gets him about halfway home.
Yes, now second and goal. The end zone beckons. It looms. They can do whatever they want. Full playbook. Run it again, or they can go play action and try and put it in that way.
On second down, here's Wilson. Touchdown, Seahawks. Now he's doing his part, but still facing a sizable deficit.
And he would like to do more, but he needs help from the other two-thirds, right? He needs his defense to bow up a little bit, and he also needs special teams to maybe create some big plays and help them get back in it.
Fairbairn good with the extra point, and that will shave one more off this lead. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This will be fielded at the six. And he'll get this just up past the 20, but a marker is down. Let's get the call. Yeah, this is going to put him back with a not great
field position.
So they really got zero benefit at all, right? Sometimes you can absorb a penalty when you get a big return, then the penalty brings it back, but you still have great field position. As you pointed out, not in this case.
So the special teams penalty cost some yardage there as they come out on first and 10. Here's Bell. And a nice move will yield nothing as he stopped behind the line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. Charles, you said earlier this defense is probably going to need to hold these guys right around 20 or under that if they were going to have a chance. It was evident pretty early on that wasn't going to happen.
Yeah, they left 20 behind a long time ago in this game, didn't they? It looks like they're headed towards a big, big number. But 20 was the threshold because that kept them in the ball game and kept the pressure off of their own offense.
They'll look to throw here, escaping the pressure right. Now he's going to throw it deep to the other side of the field. Oh, he almost had it. Already with one interception, just missing his second there. Despite the lead here in the fourth, they're still taking shots.
Not content to sit on this lead at all. And to me, it raises the question of what's right in this game nowadays. Do you sit on the ball and run it because you have enough of a lead? Or do you try and extend it because you always feel like the other team can come back?
Extend it. Have some fun.
Flex round! Flex round!
Cut! He'll look to throw. That'll be taken in there by James Washington. And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. They'll get 11, but still a little short. Fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. Here's Marquette King now. Always a good sign when your first punt comes in the fourth quarter. This is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. The Seahawks offense now, they get set to go back to work. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, first and 10 at their own 15. They start the drive with Cook. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. Steps away to his left. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
19.
Now Wilson on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Now, he's been a busy man out of the backfield. They've looked his way quite a bit so far in this game.
Nice job there defensively, though, adjusting, because a couple of his earlier catches, he was wide open. Not that time.
You mentioned the key word, adjustment. A better cover man on him now in space.
And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off at the 45. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line. Charles, whatever's going on between his ears right now, it's just not completely calculated correctly. 7 picks between last week and this week after that one.
And they always say the most important part of a player is those 6 inches between the ears. But right now, it's all those interceptions that are going on. So whoever his trusted confidant is on the sidelines, I don't know if it's the offense coordinator, the quarterback's coach, maybe the backup quarterback, that's who he needs to get with now and get himself calm.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. Forced out to his left, and it's incomplete. Time for a break.
We're back to finish this one off after this. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. On the ground they go with a running back. Bell so light on his feet. And oh, he's going to be brought down by the face mask. Here come the flags. This is going to get him a first down. They're down here in the fourth, and that personal foul penalty is not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration. Not a good play.
And now it's first and 10, a big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. After the penalty, it's Bell. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Like he'll throw here. That's caught left side by Jake Bunt. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. That catch good for five. It's third down.
And, partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal, because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
The Jets on third down. They've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This will be third and 6. Now back to throw. Found his target. It's Anderson. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals. Starting to really smell a 4-0 start right now. Can't ask for a better first quarter of the season than that.
And you're not supposed to look ahead, but guess what?
They're going to?
They have to, because when you get to 4, if you get to 4-0, you're not just thinking playoffs now. You're thinking about, okay, this team has the capabilities of winning a Super Bowl. They could very well be the best team in the NFL at this moment.
I think they played the best. I mean, there have been a few hiccups offensively and defensively, but probably the best team we've seen, right?
And has the ability to get better.
The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. That throw good for four. It's second down. You got the big lead defensively, willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
So after the penalty, now they need just a yard on second down. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. Buying time to his left. And he's taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. C.J. Mosley in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. They go play action now. Wilson. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. A big offensive explosion help leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Jets, hey, they finish a perfect month of September as they move to 4-0 on the new campaign. And they'll get to stay put for a few days as they'll host the Buffalo Bills next week. Meanwhile, for Seattle, the defeat is their first of the year as they drop to 3-1. And they'll look to get back in the winning column next week as they head to Philly to face off with the Eagles. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports.